Hey everyone, how are you doing? You have Mike here, and today we're going to take a look at the GL 2000 by Osree. So Osree had sent this light out, asked us to run it through the paces like we do all the other lights on the channel, and that's what we're going to do for you here in this video. So we're going to break down, find the power ratings coming out of it, and the energy consumption, the lights pulling from the wall, as well as find out how warm she's running, and we'll give you a summary afterwards after we're done the testing. So a little bit of information about this light. This here uses 1,344 pieces LEDs. It's using a mix of 3,000K, 5,000K, 660 nanometer, and 730 nanometer 3030 bridge lux chips. For the driver on it, it's actually using a fairly decent driver. This here is the Fahold driver. Did some research, looked this up, asked a few people about it. These have a fairly good history. They're actually a fairly decent driver. Pulls 200 watts out of this one here. It also has the capability of doing up to five lights daisy chain, which I know a lot of you guys ask about the daisy chain lights all the time. So five lights with this one here. So it has a potentiometer, and it actually comes on quite a bit of a long cord, so you can kind of put this out of your tent if you wanted to, or whatever. You could turn it right off, so from zero to turn the light right off to turning it on to 100%. So this light here is a all aluminum design, guys. So if you can take a look at the heatsink, this is a heatsink that goes right across the whole light. The driver is lifted pretty far off the light, so we shouldn't have to worry about any heat heating up the light board. And it uses a piece of plexi instead of using that coating onto the board itself, which I think is pretty neat. So I'm actually kind of excited to really get this light tested here. So this one here is going to set you back $179 US. I haven't been able to find it on Amazon Canada, so I'm not really sure what the price is in Canadian, but it comes with a 3-year warranty. And the light itself weighs 11 pounds. It's 3 feet 8 inches long and about 5 inches wide. So I think it's time to get this light here tested. So like I said, we're gonna check the PAR, check the energy consumption and the temperature, and we'll get back with all the results right here. Stay tuned. All right, guys, so we are back from testing, and yeah, let's cover some of the information that we had on the light. So let's get right into the temperatures. We'll talk about how warm she ran, and then we'll go from there into the PAR and so forth. So with the driver on this light, she came in at 59 degrees. That's still fairly reasonable. Runtime, or the cutoff temperature here, is 90 degrees Celsius, so it's far below that. And I believe all these lights are pretty much the same thing. All the drivers are pretty much the same thing. The Meanwell, the Sosan drivers, Fahold, all of them seem to be have the thermal cutoff at about 90 degrees, so they're all running within that parameter. The top of the light went to 54 degrees, and I could say that the fins were actually working really well. You could feel the heat coming off the light, and the aluminum heatsink was really doing its job. I definitely prefer these fin styles over the flat plates. The flat plates really, really just don't. They just don't do justice like these fins do. So with the bottom of the light, with the plexiglass on the bottom, it is a little bit hard to get a reading, but I actually was getting a reading of about 44 degrees. It went up to 45 at one point. So under 10 degrees difference from the top to the bottom, which is pretty much, you know, you'd like to see maybe even a degree cooler, but that's not bad at all. So taking a look at the coverage of light, we take a look at the PAR map here. The PAR maps weren't that bad. It was pretty much on average in the center, about 700, 720-ish. That's fairly decent. Actually, if you take a look comparing it to the SP250 that we had, the coverage on this light here was quite a bit better. Just the even coverage. It was just a nice even overall coverage. If you wanted to use this light in your 2x4 tent, I would probably say you could grow a nice crop with one of these, but two of these in and there would really rock, just $700 all across the board. Same thing if you wanted to do with a 4x4, if you had three of these, I mean, you would have some pretty nice coverage even in a 4x4. So it's not a bad light. So when we take a look at we did some math here. We tested the PAR and all this stuff. Energy consumption of this light was 193 watts. With 193 watts, that we can then calculate the micromole to joule, and that comes out to 2.04 at 12 inches, which is pretty good. That is better than the Mars Hydro that we tested. So, it's actually a fairly nice light, guys. So Osree has given us a little bit of a promo code, so I'm going to put that down into the description. If you guys are interested in picking up one of these lights, you can do that and get a slight discount for it, and that would be pretty sweet for you guys. So thanks, Osree, for giving us a promo code. I appreciate that. So I would like to thank everybody for watching. I do really appreciate all our viewers. If you guys have any questions, feel free to throw them down in the comments below, and you'll have yourself a great day. Take care.